I am continuing the problems on calculation of eigenvalues and eigenvectors for a square matrix. We have studied one problem on this concept, and I shall continue the next problem, how these eigenvalues and eigenvectors can be calculated. I shall write this statement of the given problem.
Find the eigenvalues and the corresponding eigenvectors of the matrix A is equal to minus 2 2, minus 1, 2, 1, minus 2, minus 3, 6, 0,
This is similar to the previous problem. In the previous problem, we came across 3 rows and 3 columns, and here also we have 3 rows and 3 columns for this square matrix. Therefore, this is 3 cross 3. That means m cross n. M is number of rows. There are 3. First row, second row, third row. First column, second column, and third column. There are 3 rows and 3 columns here also. Therefore, we have square matrix, so that you will be getting the characteristic equation with highest degree as 3. And from that characteristic equation, we can expect the 3 different values of lambda. And afterwards, for each value of lambda, we can calculate the corresponding vector, that is called eigenvector. In that eigenvector, we can find out each eigenvector, we can expect the value of x, the value of y, and the value of z. Okay. First of all, we have to write the characteristic equation for this square matrix be determinant A minus lambda I equal to 0. Determinant A minus lambda I equal to 0 means A is the given square matrix, lambda is the characteristic value or eigenvalue, and I is the identity matrix of the order which is given as 3 cross 3. That means order is 3. Order of the matrix is nothing but, anyway it is a square matrix, either the number of rows or it is the number of columns. Then determinant A minus lambda I is equal to 0, then A minus lambda I is equal to 0, accordingly we will write determinant A minus 2, 2 and minus 1, it is 2, 1, minus 2, minus 3, 6 and 0, minus of lambda, that is 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, and determinant, that is equal to 0. Here, this matrix, if you simplify, you compare with the previous problem, if you simplify, you will be getting the determinant inside that by multiplying this lambda inside and then subtracting between the given square matrix and the identity matrix which is multiplied by lambda. Then this is minus 2 minus 1 means lambda, minus 2 minus lambda, it is 2, minus 3, it is 2, it is 1 minus lambda. This is 1 into lambda with minus sign, 1 minus lambda, that is 6 minus 0, this is 2 minus 0 and 2 minus 0, minus 1 minus 0, minus 2 minus 0 and 0 minus lambda, this is equivalent to 0. Then this is a matrix inside, and for this matrix determinant is applied means
we can simplify this matrices when we apply the determinant. Okay, so when we apply the determinant means to the matrix, it can be simplified, but matrix alone cannot be simplified.
Then you take the first term, that means first number, minus 2 minus lambda, multiplied by the opposite value, so that is 1 minus lambda, 1 minus lambda into minus lambda, and minus of, it is minus 2 into 6. Okay, then this is alternately plus minus, you have to choose. Okay, this is for plus, this is for minus, and this is for plus. Then minus 2 you have to take into, that is this much, 2 into minus lambda. Okay, and then that means corresponding column you have to ignore and corresponding row you have to ignore, 6. That is 2 into minus lambda, that is minus of 6 into minus 1. So this is enough. Then alternately plus minus you have to take, minus 3 minus 0 means it is minus already there, into plus, that becomes minus, and you have to ignore this last column, you have to ignore the first row. Then 2 into minus 2, you have to take 2 into minus 2. Then minus 1, minus of minus 1 into, that is 1 minus lambda, 1 minus lambda. Then this is to be equated to 0. This is to be equated to 0. Now you release all these terms, that is minus 2 minus lambda. Take the multiplication inside, this is minus lambda into minus minus plus, it is lambda square, and here it is minus 2, 6 2s are 12, that is plus of 12 you can get, and inside here that is 2 is there, minus 2, that you can write it as minus 2 into this minus 4 lambda, and this is minus into minus plus, this becomes minus, and then it is 12, then this becomes minus 3 into, that is 2 2s are 4, 4 3s are 12, minus into minus, that becomes plus sign, that is 12, and take this minus 3 inside, that is minus 3 into minus, that is plus 3, plus 3, minus 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 3 times minus, so minus 3, and minus minus minus, and one more minus, it is plus of 3 times lambda, that is equal to 0. Then we can simplify, that is minus 2 minus lambda, minus 2 minus lambda, that should be multiplied to, anyway this is minus lambda plus lambda square, and that is plus of 12, okay, and plus of, it is 4 with minus lambda, and then minus 12, minus 12, and plus of 12, plus of 12, minus 3, and plus of 3 lambda equal to 0. Then by minus 2 you multiply to all these terms, minus 2 lambda, that becomes plus lambda, minus 2 into this one, 2 times of lambda square, that is minus 24, and minus minus plus lambda square, and minus lambda cube, and minus 12 lambda, and this becomes minus of 4 lambda, and minus 12, and plus 12, okay, and minus 3, and plus 3 lambda, that is equal to 0. Then you can simplify, that is lambda cube, this is only one term with minus, lambda square 2 times, this is minus lambda, 2 lambda square and lambda, that is minus lambda square, and lambda is 2 lambda, this is minus 12 lambda, that is minus 12 lambda means minus 10 lambda, minus 14 lambda, minus 14 means this is minus 11 lambda, minus 11 lambda, and the constants, this is minus 24, okay, and this plus 12 will come cancel, and this is 3, it is minus of 3 you will be getting. So minus 24 minus 3 minus 27, okay, this is equal to minus 27. So minus 27 equal to 0. So this is the equation equation after the simplification. So this is the heat, and if you want to remove minus sign, that is lambda cube plus lambda square plus 11 lambda and plus of, it is 27, and that is equal to 0. This is the entire part is with minus sign, and this is the characteristic equation. So from this characteristic equation you have to find out the values of lambda. So lambda is equal to minus 1 and lambda is equal to minus 2, lambda is equal to minus 3, like that. So for which number this satisfies, you have to find out the corresponding values of lambda, and for each value of lambda, that is, you have to calculate the corresponding eigen vectors. Then let us verify for which value this equation satisfies. Let lambda is equal to area all are plus, you need not to take plus value, you have to go for only minus value. Lambda is equal to minus 1 means minus 1 plus 1 minus 11 and plus 27. This is equal to 27, 28 and 12, that is 16, is not equal to 0. Lambda is equal to 2, minus 2. So minus 8 plus 4 minus 22, this one, plus 27. This is equal to, this is minus 8 and minus 22 is minus 30, and this is 27 plus 4, that is 31. Okay, so 1, which is not equal to 0. Lambda is equal to minus 3. Then minus 3 means minus 27, this is plus of 9, square it is, and minus of 33 plus 27. We will verify this. And plus 27, and this is also not going to become 0. 27, and this is 24, that is minus 24 is not equal to 0. So like this you go on calculating for which number it satisfies, then that number will be one among the values. Afterwards you divide by that factor so that you will be getting other values. Therefore you can write the corresponding eigenvectors for this one. Then lambda is equal to minus 5, lambda is equal to minus 5, it may satisfy. Likewise you have to calculate the corresponding eigenvectors. So you verify from this one for which number it satisfies, you go on putting those numbers and calculate. You simply refer the previous problem. So this is one example like finding the eigenvalues and eigenvector. Let me write another equation also. I shall give the characteristic equation for that, then you have to verify. Next example, that is find the eigenvalues and the corresponding eigenvectors of the matrix A is equal to, it is 2, minus 1, 1, minus 1, 2, minus 1, and it is 1, minus 1, it is 2.
Sometimes it will take more number of values, sometimes within 1 or 2, 3 values you will be getting the corresponding values of lambda.
Let us see how this matrix divides. then define the characteristic equation as determinant A minus lambda I equal to 0. Then determinant, the given matrix, it is 2 minus 1 1 minus 1 2 minus 1 1 minus 1 it is 2 and minus of lambda into 1 0 0, then it is 0 1 0 0 0 1. This is equal to 0. Then you can write that determinant after taking this 2, 2 minus 1, 1, minus 1, 2, minus 1, 1 minus 1, 2, that is 2 minus lambda from this. Okay, so minus 1 minus 0, 1 minus 0, and next is minus 1 minus lambda, that means 0, and here 2 minus lambda, and minus 1 minus 0, 1 minus 0, minus 1 minus 0, and 2 minus lambda, that is equal to 0. So now also you simplify this value, that is this matrix, because we have applied the determinant. So 2 minus lambda, 2 minus lambda multiplied by, this is 2 minus lambda and 2 minus lambda whole square. Then cross multiplication here, minus 1 minus 0 is minus 1, this is also minus 1. Minus of minus 1 into minus 1, and minus 1 minus 0, this is minus of minus 1 multiplied by this into this. Okay, that is 2 minus lambda whole square, and this completes. Then minus 1 with another minus, according to the rule of simplification, between these two you have to multiply, that is minus 1 into 2 minus lambda, okay, and between these two, that is minus of, it is minus 1 into 1, that is over, and plus 1 multiplied by, you have to ignore this last column and you have to ignore the corresponding row, between these two, that is minus 1 into minus 1, okay, and 1 into it is 2 minus lambda, that is equated to 0. Then 2 minus lambda multiplied by, this is 4 minus, this must be 4 lambda plus lambda square, and 3 times minus means minus 1, and here minus sign is there, that is minus into minus plus sign, and inside the bracket minus 2 and plus lambda, and this becomes plus 1, okay, and plus of 1 into, this is 1, and minus 2 and plus of lambda, that is equated to 0. Then you can take the simplification for one more step. 2 minus lambda, that is 4, that means lambda square and minus 4 lambda and plus of 3 and plus of, this is lambda and plus of minus of 1 and plus of, this is lambda and minus 1, that is equated to 0. Then you simplify again for this. This is 2 minus lambda. By 2 I will multiply all the 3 terms. It is 2 times of lambda square, this one, minus 8, minus 4 into 2, minus 8, and plus 6 by 2, you have multiplied all these 3 terms. And next by minus lambda, you have to multiply, minus lambda cube, and plus of 4 lambda, plus of 4 lambda, and minus of 3 lambda, and plus lambda, minus 1, and plus lambda, minus 1, equal to 0. Now you simplify this, that is lambda cube, first term with minus, lambda square, only one term remains, I think, lambda square, that is 2 times of lambda square, okay, and that is lambda. So here there is no lambda, it is multiplied, and we will verify. That is lambda square, 4 times of lambda, that is 2 minus lambda, and the lambda terms are, that is lambda cube from this, and 4 times of lambda minus 3 times of lambda, that is lambda square is plus of 2 times lambda square, and 4 times of lambda, that is plus lambda, and 4 plus 1 5 plus 1 6, 6 minus 3 lambda, this is 3 lambda, and minus 1 minus 1 minus 2 and plus 6 plus 4 equal to 0. That is lambda cube minus of 2 times lambda square, and plus of becomes minus 3 times lambda, minus 4 equal to 0. So this is your characteristic equation. That means f of lambda, that is equal to 0. So from this you have to calculate the corresponding values of lambda, and for what values you go on checking from this, and then you can arrive at the conclusion what are the values of lambda. They are called as eigenvalues, and for each value the corresponding eigenvector. So like this I will write another 2-3 problems, you can practice that. Example, find the characteristic equation of A is equal to the matrix given like this, 1, 4, 1, 3, 2, 2, 7, 3, that is 1, okay. Next is, find the eigenvalues, find the eigenvalues and the eigenvector, find the eigenvalues and the eigenvector of the matrix, eigenvalues and eigenvector of the matrix A is equal to, that is 6 minus 2, 2, minus 2, 3, minus 1, 2, minus 1, it is 3. So this is the matrix. For this only the characteristic equation, but for this you have to find out the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of the matrix. Then I shall give totally 4 problems whatever we studied so far. I shall give one problem in each case, how this matrix methods can be applied to solve the system of linear equations, even by finding the rank, even by finding the consistency, and the Gauss elimination method, and also eigenvalues and eigenvectors.
conclusion, in all the four topics what we studied, I will write one example, then I will solve all those four examples according to your syllabus. First topic is we have studied as rank of the matrix, and second topic is consistency, that is by finding the rank of augmented matrix and the rank of the coefficient matrix. And next is Gauss elimination method, and the next is eigenvalues and eigenvectors of the matrix. So I will write totally four problems respectively: what is the rank of the matrix, what is the consistency of the system of linear equations, and what is by Gauss elimination method that we are going to apply, and another one is what are the eigenvalues and eigenvectors. To conclude this module, I will take four examples from this discussions in the module number, that is module 1, according to 18 mat dip 41. So now one example. So that is rank of the matrix. First topic, and next is consistency of system of linear equations. System of linear equations, and next is Gauss elimination method, and eigenvalues and eigenvectors. Eigenvalues and eigenvectors of a square matrix. So these are the four topics we studied. Okay. In this one example I will solve in order to give the conclusion of this module. Okay. Example number 1. Find the rank of the matrix. Find the rank of the matrix A is equal to 6, 2 with minus 2, minus 2, then 3, minus 1 and 2, minus 1 and 3. Solution. A is equal to this much means rank using elementary row operation method. We have discussed already, but as a conclusion part, last example I am writing one sample in all the four topics what we discussed in this module 1. Okay. So I should use the elementary row operation method. Even I will compare this with another method. The rank must be same from both the cases. Okay. That means by determinant method also you can find the rank, but determinant method will not be used much in the applications area, because when we have more number of rows and more number of columns, otherwise more number of elements inside the matrix, then determinant method will become very tedious. It will become very lengthy procedure. Then normally we don't take that determinant method to be verified, to be applied for finding the rank of the matrix. Then we will, but in this problem I will compare both. Okay. First step, by elementary row operation method, elementary row operation method, what is that? A is equal to the given matrix as it is, you write 6, minus 2 and plus 2, minus 2, it is 3, and then minus 1, 2, it is minus 1, and then it is 3. Then, so by elementary row operation method, let me recall what we discussed. The first element or the element from the first row as first element should be the non-zero number. It must be pivotal. It is called as pivotal element, but it must be always non-zero number.
So non-zero number is, this is obviously 6 is not the zero. Therefore, pivotal element is 6, and these two elements we have to make them as 0. This is called R1, this is called R2, this is called R3. Then we can write R1 and plus of, this is 3 times R2 affecting on R2. R1, here 6 is there, minus 6 makes us 0. Here 6 is there, here also minus 6. By minus 3 you have to multiply, that is R3, affecting on R3. Then this is equivalent to, 6 minus 2 plus 2, you write as this, and here 0, and R1 plus 3, R2. R1 is minus 2, 3 R2 is, 3 3s are 9. 9 minus 2, that is minus 2 plus 9. 9 minus 2 plus 9 is plus 6. Okay. But 3 3 is 9, sorry, this is 7. That is R1 means minus 2 and 3 3 is 9, plus 9. That is plus of 7. Next is R1, that is 3 times, plus 3 times R2. 2 times minus 3, that is minus 1. Next is, here R1 minus 3 times R2, anyway it is 0, we made it. And R1 is minus 2 and minus 3, this becomes plus 1. And R1 is 2 and minus 3, this is minus 9, it is minus of 7. So this is once row operation what we did, we are getting the result. Then these two elements are, we made them as 0. Now this becomes the pivotal element. Number 7 becomes the pivotal element. This is PE. This is PE, pivotal element. So we have to make this element as 0. We have to make this element as 0 means, we have to make use of second element in the second row. Should be the non-zero number which acts as pivotal element. With that, we have to make this element as 0. Therefore, this is R2. What we have to take? R2 as it is, because previous row we are not disturbed. Minus of 7, this is R3. Minus of 7, R3. And affecting on, this is R3. Then, that is enough.
Because only first row on the second and third, and second row on the third row, only these two are the operations we have to take. Okay,
then what we have to take is, that is 6 minus 2 and plus 2, it is same, and second row is not to be disturbed, that is minus 1, 0. This is 0 we made. R2 minus 7 times R3. R2 is minus 1 and 7, minus 7 times means 49. It is plus 49 means 48. So this is, we made as these three elements as 0.
That means we operated first row on second and third. Then we operated second row on the third one.
Afterwards, now you have to count
how many non-zero rows are left. How many non-zero rows are left means,
this is 48, which is not a 0. Therefore, we don't call it as
third row completely as 0 row.
Therefore, this implies rank of the matrix, is equal to number of, it is non-zero rows, number of non-zero rows, that is equal to 1, 2, 3. That means
number of non-zero rows are 3. Then number of non-zero rows are 3 means it must be rank of that given matrix.
R of A is equal to 3.
So the rank of the matrix is equal to 3. This is by elementary row operation. But the same problem we can verify. whether 3 is correct or not by determinant method. When you apply determinant, if the determinant of this given matrix is not equal to 0, then the rank of the matrix is 3. If the determinant is equal to 0, then rank of the matrix is not equal to 3. It may be 2 or it may be less than 3. Let us verify.
Second method, by determinant method. By determinant method, then A is equal to, that should be 6 minus 2 and plus 2. Minus 2, it is 3 minus 1, it is 2 minus 1 and 3. Then determinant of A, apply determinant. Applying determinant method we find the rank. Then apply the determinant for the given matrix as it is. Then we will verify whether determinant is equal to 0 or not. That is 6 minus 2 plus 2 minus 2, 3 minus 1, 2 minus 1 and 3, determinant you have to apply. Okay, so determinant means simplification. That is 6 in the first element, and ignore this row and ignore this column. That is 3 3s are 9, and minus into minus, this is minus minus plus and minus 1. Now minus of, it is minus 2. You have to ignore the middle column and ignore the first row. Then between these two, it is 2 3s are 6 with minus, and minus of, it is 2, that becomes plus sign because minus sign is there. Then plus of 2 and multiplied by, ignore this last column and ignore the corresponding row, between minus 2 and minus 1, that is plus 2, multiplication, and 3 and 2, that is 6. Then you consider this simplification, 9 minus 1, 6 into 8, okay, and plus 2 into minus 4, and plus 2 into minus 4. Then this is 6 8s of 48. Then this is minus 8, minus 8, and it is plus 8, sorry, minus 8, 4 2s are 8, okay. Then 16 here, that is 42, that means 48 minus 16, that is equal to 32. 48, 8 minus 8 and minus 8, that is minus 16. Then 48 minus 16, that is equal to 32, which is not equal to 0, that is determinant of A. Implies rank of A is equal to 3. Rank of A is equal to 3. That implies R of A equal to 3. So rank of A is equal to 3 because the determinant is not equal to 0. If it is equal to 0, then we will try for next minor order. This is the major order, like 3 cross 3. Minor square order means it is 2 cross 2, next 1 cross 1. But if in case all the possible minors, when you are going to select from this matrix, if all of them are leading to 0, first of all, this 3 cross 3 determinant is equal to 0, then rank is not equal to 3, then we will choose minor of order 2 cross 2, then also we will verify if all the minors are leading to 0,
then rank is not 2, rank is not 3. Then in such cases 1 cross 1 need not to verify, because any scalar matrix, any scalar matrix, that means not a null matrix, in that matrix the minimum rank is equal to 1. In case all the order, that means a determinant, when you are going to calculate above that first order or leading to 0, then a rank of the matrix is as a minimum is equal to 1. Therefore, this is by determinant method, and by elementary operation also the rank of the matrix was 3, and that is going to match with the direct calculation, that is by determinant method.
So one more problem of consistency of the equations I will take, then I shall solve that also by elementary operation method. I shall take one example on that. Test for consistency. Test for consistency and solve the system of linear equations. The system of linear equations. Those equations are, it is 2x plus 2y plus z equal to 3, x plus 3y and plus z equal to 1, and x plus 2y plus 2z equal to 4. Test for consistency and solve. Let us see how this equation behaves. So test for consistency means what?
We are going to find out the rank of coefficient matrix and rank of augmented matrix. So rank of coefficient matrix is nothing but coefficients of the unknowns.
So let us write the first step. Let Ax equal to b be the matrix equation. Let Ax equal to b be the matrix equation such that that is coefficient matrix, it is 2 1 1, it is 2 3 2, 1 1 it is 2, x y z, and it is equal to 3 1 4. Now as it is, you apply, because already you are familiar
In handling the equations as they are with the coefficient matrix and augmented matrix.
Augmented matrix means that we are inserting the values of this column inside this, then you are going to treat that as
3 rows and 4 columns. That means here at present we have coefficient matrix is square matrix. When you add this column here besides 1, 1, 2, that becomes 3 rows and 4 columns.
Then we use elementary row operation technique. How this elementary row operation method is going to be applied? That is by elementary row operation method. We have the two elements, we have to make them as 0 with the help of the first element. That means first element is, it is pivotal element PE. Then these two elements we have to make them as 0. Then R, this is R1 minus of 2 times R2, affecting not R2, R1 minus 2 times R3, affecting on R3. So here 2 is there, you must expect minus 2. Here 2 is there, you must expect minus 2. So this is 2, this is 2, 1 as they are, this is 0, multiplied by x, y, z, and this is equal to 3 as it is. And then we have to write here as 0, that is R1 minus 2 R2, affecting on R2. Okay, so that is here it is 0, then R1 minus 2 times of R2. 2 times means 6 here, minus 6, minus 6 plus 2, that is minus 4. Then here minus 2 times means minus 1, and here it is, this is 0 anyway, this is also R1 minus 2, because 2 minus 4 that becomes here, that is minus 3. Then this becomes R1 minus 2 times R2, that is 1, R1 minus 2 times of R3, that is 4 times of 8, that is minus of 5.
So this is one step operation, that means R1 on the remaining rows.
So now we shall take another next step, that is what elementary row operation is going to be applied. Then what is the row operation you are going to do? That here this becomes the pivotal element, and this becomes the element to be converted as 0 by not disturbing the previous row, that is R2 as it is, you have to write, and minus of 2 times R3 affecting on R3, because minus 4 is there. If you are getting here plus 4, then addition gives us 0. Therefore minus 2 is there, minus 2 be removed means minus sign, you multiply, and from this 2 you must get it as, that is multiplication as 2, you will get it as finally, that is 4. Then you must write the elementary row operation, that is 2, 2, 1, and this is 0, this is 0, this is minus 4, this is 0, and x, y, z. Then on the right side, that is 3, 1, and this, in this place R2 minus 2 R3 affecting on this one. R2, this is minus 1, minus 2 R3, 3 2s are 6, and minus sign is there, that is plus 5 we are getting. Then here R2 is 1, minus it is 10, but that becomes minus minus plus 10. Therefore, this is 11.
Now you can sort out what is the rank of coefficient matrix and what is the rank of, that is, augmented matrix.
Here, R of A is equal to number of non-zero rows. Non-zero rows. R of A means this is A, that is equal to, anywhere 5 is there, you can write it as 3. Then augmented matrix R of AB, same thing, rows, that is equal to 3. Therefore R of A equal to R of, it is AB, R of A is equal to R of AB. Then implies the given system, the given system of equations is said to be, the given system of equations is said to be consistent, consistent, and the solution is as follows. Solution is as follows. That means reconstructing the equations we have first row, that is 2x plus 2y plus z equal to, that is row is transposed to column, 2 into x plus 2 into y plus 1 into z, therefore equated to 3. Here minus 4y and this is 5. it is 1, 5 and then it is 3. I did not write here one element. Let me assume that some number as C1 because already already I have got it and find out what is the element. Let me write this one is C1, no problem. In terms of C1 I will write minus 4y, it is plus 5z is equal to 1 and it is C1 into z is equal to 11. Okay, then I hope this C5 will be the last number. It seems, let me check that. That is R1. Here R1 minus 2 times R2. Okay, R1 minus 2 times R2, that gives 1 minus, that is minus 1. Okay, and then R1 minus R2, that is 2 here, minus R2, R1 minus 2 times of R2, that is 2 times of R2 means 6, that is 4, and R1 minus 2 times of R2, that is minus 1, I think, 1 here, R1 minus 2 times of R2, 1 minus of 1 means this should be minus 1, then I will remove this C1. Okay, then this must be, it is not C1, it is 5 and this is minus 1. So this is minus of Z and this is 5. So thereby the third equation gives Z is equal to 11.5 and substituting in place of Z you will collect the value of, that is Y. What is that? Second value of the unknown. Okay, minus 4y here and equal to 1 plus z. So z equal to 11.5. This is equal to 16.5. Then y is equal to 4 4s are 16, that is minus of 4/5. This is the value of y and this is the value of z. And this equation, we can collect the value of x, that is 2x is equal to 3. Take these two terms to the other side, minus z and minus of 2y. So this is 3 minus z means minus 11/5 and minus 2, that is minus 8/5. So 5 3s of 15 minus 11 minus 8 divided by 5, that is 15 minus 19 and divided by 5. 5 3 is 15 minus 11 minus 8 because 5 is the LCM. Then 15 minus 11 minus 8, that is minus 19, and this is equal to minus 4 divided by 5. 15 minus 19 is minus 4. Therefore, x is equal to, this is 2 is there, so 2 to the 4, minus 2 divided by 5, this is the value. So these three values will satisfy the equation, hence we consider these three values as solutions of the equations. Okay, so next is a Gauss elimination method I will take. How this Gauss elimination method works for the given values. Directly I will write the problem, solve. Six x minus 2y plus 2z equal to 2. minus 2x plus 3y minus z equal to 1 and 2x minus y and 3z plus 3z equal to 3 using Gauss elimination method. Using Gauss elimination method. Solution.
So Gauss elimination method, we don't check the rank of coefficient matrix and rank of the augmented matrix. So directly we solve the equations by elementary row operation by in order to eliminate the unknowns. So that one after the other, the elements can be, unknowns can be eliminated.
So let us verify. Given Ax equal to b as the matrix equation. That is, you write Ax equal to b form, that is 6, then minus 2, and then plus 2. Then minus 2, 3, and then minus 1, it is 2, and minus 1, 3, multiplied by x, y, z. Then on the right side, it is 2, 1, and then 3. This is
the matrix form of the equation you are going to write. And then Gauss elimination method means you are going to make these two elements as 0. Exactly by row operation method, but here we don't compare the ranks of augmented and coefficient matrix. That is the difference.
Then these two elements we make them as 0 with the help of this pivotal element, that is plus 3 times R2, and effecting on this is R2. Then R1 minus of 3 times R3, effecting on R3. Then you will get 6, and then minus 2, it is plus 2, and x, y, z, it is equated to 2, and then here that is 0, and here that is R1 plus 3 times, that means 9, R1 plus 3 times means 9 means it is 7, and then R1. Okay, plus 3 times, that is minus 1, R1 plus 3 times, that is 5, and then 0, this one, and R1 minus 3 times. So minus 3 means this becomes plus 1, and R1 minus 3, minus 9, minus 9 means minus 7, and then R1, it is minus 3, minus 7. This is also minus 7. Okay? I hope this one. R1 minus 3, R3. R1 minus 3, R3. That is 2 minus 9 becomes 7. Okay. Now, this element you have to make it as 0 with the help of this 7. Okay? That too not disturbing the previous one. That is R2 minus 7 times R3. Effecting on it is R3. Then, you write the possible values there, 6, 0, 0, and then minus 2, it is 7, and then 0, it is 2, minus 1, we will verify what number we are getting, and x, y, z, and that is equal to 2, and then 5, and last number we will check, that is R2 minus 7 times R3. R2, this is minus 1, and minus 7 times R3, that is 49, minus 1 plus 49, this becomes, I hope it is 48, correct? R2 is minus 1, minus 7, okay, R2 here, minus 1, minus 7 into minus 7 is 49, and that becomes 48 with plus sign. Okay. Then R2, here it is 5, right? And minus 7 means plus 49. This becomes 54, right? So this is the value of the simplification, that is R2. R2 is 5, and minus 7 times R3, 5, that is 7 sevens are 49. So this is 54. Then row operation procedure is over, because chance of using first row on the remaining and second and first row on the third row is completed. So now you have to construct the equations as they are. 6x minus 2, that means form the equations. Forming the equations. 6x minus 2y plus 2z equal to 2, 7y minus z equal to 5, 48z equal to, it is 54. Then this implies z is equal to 54 divided by 48. This is first value. Then 7y is equal to 5 plus z. This is equal to 5 plus 54 divided by, it is 48. Then this becomes y is equal to 1 by 7 multiplied by 5 plus 54 divided by 48. You can simplify this. So this is the value of y. Then z is over, y is over, then you have to calculate the x value. That is 6x is equal to 2 minus 2z and plus 2y. This is 2 minus 2z, 2 into, it is 54 by 48, plus 2 into 2 by 7 into, that is 5 plus 54 by, it is 48. Okay. Then x is equal to 1 by 6 multiplied to 2 minus, it is 2 into 54 divided by 48 plus of 2 by 7 into 5 plus 54 by, it is 48. So this is the value of x. All these three values give the idea that the solution of the given equations, where you can verify the, by substituting these values in the given equations, they must satisfy. Thereby, we call this method as Gauss elimination method. Step by step, the numbers we have eliminated, and afterwards these numbers can be verified whether they will satisfy the equations or not. Okay, this is Gauss elimination method. And finally, one problem I will solve today, what we discussed as eigenvalues and then eigenvectors. One last sample I will take on the eigenvalues and eigenvectors. Example, find the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of the matrix A is equal to, find the eigenvalues and the eigenvectors of the matrix that is 2, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, that is 1, 2. We will see that what are the eigenvalues for this matrix. Solution 2, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 2. Therefore, define, what is the first step? The characteristic equation as A minus lambda I under the determinant equal to 0. So now I will write directly, that is determinant of, that is 2 minus lambda 1 0 0 1 minus lambda 0 0 that is 1 1 it is 2 minus lambda. This is equal to 0. So now you simplify this. 2 minus lambda, 1 minus lambda into 2 minus lambda and minus of 1 into 0, that is 0, and minus 1 into, this is 0, 0, and minus of, this is 0. 1 minus lambda, 2 minus lambda product, this is 0, and minus 1 into, 0 into this much, 0 into this much, this is 0, and plus last term itself is 0. Then, so this is 0 and last term is 0. This is 2 minus lambda multiplied by 1 minus lambda into 2 minus lambda. 1 into 2 minus lambda minus 2 lambda and plus of lambda square and minus 0. This is equal to 0. Then you can write, this is 2 minus lambda multiplied by, this is 2 minus 3 lambda and plus lambda square, this is equated to 0. Then you take the multiplication by 2, this is 4, and then minus 6 lambda and plus 2 times of lambda square and minus 2 times of lambda and plus 3 times of lambda square and minus of lambda cube, that's equal to 0. 4, this is 2 3s are 6 with minus, and 2 times lambda square minus 2 lambda and minus into minus plus 3 lambda square, and it is minus lambda cube is equal to 0. There are 2 terms, that is 5 lambda square and 6, this is 8 lambda, this is 8 lambda and plus of 4 equal to 0. That is lambda cube and minus 5 lambda square plus 8 lambda and minus 4 equal to 0. So this is called characteristic equation. Characteristic equation. Then you need to calculate the corresponding eigen values. Let us verify for what number this satisfies. Let lambda is equal to 1. So lambda is equal to 1 means 1 minus 5 plus 8 and minus 4. This is equal to 8 and 1. Okay. 8 and 1, that is 9. Minus 9, that's equal to 0. Implies. So lambda minus 1 equal to 0 is one factor. Is one factor. So that we will find out the remaining factors. Then you have to divide by lambda minus 1. Okay. Then lambda minus 1. Lambda minus 1 into, that is lambda cube. Lambda cube minus 5 lambda square plus 8 lambda minus 4. You have to divide this. So lambda square, lambda cube minus 5 times, minus lambda square. This cancels. Subtraction, this is 5 plus 1, that is minus of 4 lambda square plus 8 lambda. You club this. Okay, then by minus 4 times lambda, minus 4 times lambda square and plus of 4 lambda. This becomes 0. Then 8 lambda minus 4 means 4 lambda minus 4. Then plus 4 you take 4 lambda and minus of 4. So remainder is 0. This clearly implies lambda minus 1 into, it is lambda square minus 4 lambda, lambda square minus 4 lambda, and plus 4 equal to 0. Therefore, this happens to be, that is lambda minus 1 into lambda, this is minus 2 whole square is equal to 0. So, lambda is equal to 1 and lambda is equal to 2 and lambda is equal to 2 are the eigenvalues.
I hope you can proceed with this. When once you get the eigenvalues and eigenvectors for each value of the eigenvalue, you can find the corresponding eigenvector. So, rest of the procedure you can do that by looking to the problem already we have solved.